Now and catch up with South Australian Liberal Senator Alex Antic. Good to talk to you again, Alex. I want to get your thoughts on your own Liberal Premier in South Australia, Stephen Marshall. I don't think this has got enough attention around the country. Actually forcing people who have turned up at an event at a restaurant or a winery where there's been an infection, people who normally would isolate at home, people who have tested negative but need to keep isolating for 2 weeks, forcing them into hotel quarantine. Isn't that a dramatic infringement of their human rights?
Well, I think it's an entirely dramatic thing to do, Chris. And let's be clear, this is a direction of the state coordinator, which is the chief commissioner of police, but who has done a very good job. But this is a bridge too far. I mean, frankly, what we're talking about here is detaining people who have committed no crime, who have done nothing other than simply visit sites in the last week, who are now being told in some cases that they need to attend a midi hotel, which is done in some cases against their will, although we're being told that they've been done in consultation. But regardless of that, I mean, this is now saying to people, if you do the right thing, if you check your QR codes and you come in, you're still going to be liable to go through this draconian process. This system is just, it's no longer fit for purpose. These lockdowns are a blunt instrument. We've had 18 months to get this right, and frankly, we have to do better.
Well, Stephen Marshall, as a Liberal Premier, I keep saying this is not a party political issue because he's one of the premiers most prone to lockdowns. He's a lockdown fetishist. He's locked down before based on wrong information. He slammed borders shut. I mean, obviously, he thinks this is going to play into his election in March the same way it did do for Mark McGowan and Anastasia Palaszczuk.
Well, I think one of the problems here, Chris, is that what we're seeing is this health bureaucracy in South Australia running rampant. And I think one of the things we get out of this is that these health bureaucracies of all kinds, run on a very different clock than they do out in the public and the private sector. We get criticism all the time that, you know, they're not taking a pay cut, they're not having to throw away stock, the private sector is. And I think that's what we see with these elimination strategies. We are seeing strategies which just simply are no longer working. We saw people queuing for 12 hours sometimes yesterday to be tested. I mean, people are getting sick of this. They are going to continue to get sick of this, and they're right to be sick of this. And look, I agree with you when I say that I would like to see more Liberals. I mean, Nicole Flint, Tony Passon, Rowan Ramsey have all spoken out for their community, but I would like to see more Liberals reminded of what Sir Robert Menzies would have done in this situation, which is to respect people's freedom and liberty and the economy, which is taking a very big hit on all of this. I fear that those two, three things may actually end up being more heavily impacted than the public health side of things. We're talking about 40,000 tests that have been done in the last 48 hours. It's located three cases. Now, we don't want any cases, of course, but we've got to live in the real world. That is hardly super spreading, Chris. There has to be another way.
He's using language like catastrophic and, as you say, super spreading when there's only one case today. And he says he's not forced anyone into hotel quarantine. It's recommended to them, but he has the power to force them. So they turn up with their health authorities or police and say, we're going to take you by ambulance to hotel quarantine. I'm not surprised no one says no.
It's pretty hard to imagine anyone saying no if a policeman turns up at the door and says, you've got to get out. I mean, this is part of the problem, all right? We've been told 48 hours ago, in fact, some of the bureaucrats in the state were telling us to, you know, thank you very much to South Australians. You're all doing a good job. You're all cooperating. And then within 24 hours after that, all of a sudden, they don't trust South Australians anymore to do the right thing and stay in isolation. Well, something's changed. I think we've got to get over this business about continuing to say we're going to eliminate this virus. We are not. We've got to find a way to learn to live with it, contain it, work on our health system, and find ways to track it, because we're going to be living with this for a very long time and we can't keep locking down.
You mentioned the role of the health bureaucracy. Well, the chief health officer in South Australia is Dr. Nicola Spurrier. I'll show you a graphic here where Janet Albrechtsen on Twitter has talked about how weird it is to watch her become such a celebrity. Journos celebrating their wannabe celebrities. People in South Australia are suffering and they're enjoying the silly jokes, attention-seeking jokes about Nicola Spurrier. She's become something of a celebrity, yet this is the health officer who said last year there was a new strain in South Australia. There was not. She also said that the virus could be carried on pizza boxes. It could not. She also told people not to duck the footy at footy matches, yet they're still putting all their faith in her.
Well, look, I mean, I think, you know, we're talking about separate and distinct issues there of, you know, professional stuff, that's all good. We trust people's judgment. There's no issue with that. But I think this issue you're talking about is this sort of cult of celebrity here. I think when you're talking to South Australians who are out there, business owners who are throwing away stock, you know, very serious issues with their payroll, very serious issues generally, I don't think it's a good look to be turning this into a celebrity event. You know, this Where's Wally thing the other day. I think people just want to see us get on with the job and come up with a strategy that is better suited and better fit for purpose. Frankly, I think that's what South Australians want.
Thanks for joining us, Alex. I appreciate it.
Thanks, Chris.